Celtic fans will juggle any means of transport to get to Seville. I'm in Paris, about to board the night train for Madrid, and I'm not alone.
He's defying his doctor to be here, but Rab Riley wouldn't miss the final for the world. The Cote Bridge demolition man smoked 80 cigarettes a day and had the last of four cardiac arrests less than a fortnight before he left home.
Because I had a heart attack a couple of weeks ago, I've actually got to go with train because I'm up in my 6Y. But I went with bike for this game.
Some people might say that you shouldn't be here at all.
I know, that's because somebody wanted my ticket. I'm delighted to see this game, and I don't think I'll ever see another one. I think this is
I'm a babysitter. Got to take care of him. He's not keeping too well. He shouldn't really be here, but he's not going to. Nobody's going to stop him. He's coming himself, so I might as well come and help him.
We travelled from Jersey over to St Malo to Rennes, Rennes to Paris, and now we're on this train, having a good drink, having a good time.
It's your 25th wedding anniversary on the 20th of May, yeah? And my wife and my three boys have bought me a ticket and the excursion ticket to get to Seville to support Celtic, so that's why I'm here.
Can I just say that's an extraordinary anniversary present?
It is, but she's an extraordinary girl.
I'm originally from Toronto, living in Glasgow at the moment, and just started a tour around Europe and stopping off to meet some mates for the match. Don't have a ticket, but I'm just going down for the party.
They say all roads lead to Rome, but for Celtic fans everywhere, whatever the journey, there could be only one destination.
Tokyo, Amsterdam, Amsterdam to Madrid.
I flew from Manchester to Frankfurt to Madrid, and I've just got the train down here and there.
You got a ticket for the game?
No.
Tay Beg and his pals from Glasgow had long-standing plans to go to London for a stag weekend. But they had itchy feet and ended up here in Seville, just in time for the match. Good for them, you might say. But there's just one slight problem.
I was getting married tomorrow, but the thing with the match final's on as well, so the match final was more important than the wedding. And the parents, they were saying, no, you need to go to the wedding, this and that. So they're expecting me to be there in Lahore, Pakistan, tomorrow. But I'm going to be at the final, which they don't know right now.
We're going to try to explain. We're explaining to the family the wedding date can be changed, but the date for the final can't be changed.
Everyone thought, we'll just blame it on one another, and then we'll just take it from there.
How many guests at the wedding?
Well, to be honest, we usually is about, we know for sure it's about 600-700 people from Paisley Road going anyway, and there's another about 600-700 from the girls' side. And all in all, I think it's going to be 1,500 people there waiting for the groom, which is, of course, Tay. But like I said, football comes first.
1,500 guests.
1,500. Everything's been arranged for.
A bride?
Bride.
But no groom?
No, the groom's obviously here, but the groom's going to be there as well. But for the time being, like I say, is earlier on, the lassie's waited 20 years. Why not wait another day?
What was the reaction?
They're not happy about it anyway.
What did they say?
They're not happy. They're saying that you let me down and everything, so I'll just told them I can't be bothered with this anything.
Are you going to stay for the game?
I'll definitely stay for the game.
He's not stood still since his first ever flight. James Traquair has yet to find match tickets for the four generations of his family who are here in Seville.
Right. I know who you are, Jimmy. What's your name?
I'm Tommy, his son.
And your son? What's
Jim.
Your name? And you are?
Jim, his son.
And you are?
Ryan, his grandson.
And you are?
Derek, his great-grandson.
And shouldn't you be at school for your maths exam?
Aye. I've got my higher maths today, but I'm here, so...
There's a bit of a queue down in Glasgow Airport, isn't it?
Yeah.
Big, very big queue. But they got the answer, son.
And do you remember, were you worried at all when you got on the aircraft?
Yeah, I was a wee bit, aye, but then when I got on the plane, I even looked out the window.
Worried about him being tired, but he's lasting well. He's going strong. Plenty of food and plenty of water, that'll be him.
He's the man behind the hits of Westlife and others, but John McLaughlin's in Seville to repay an old debt to his father.
My dad missed the 67 final because our twin sisters were born then.
So born in June,
they were born in June, but you couldn't go because of that.
That's right, no. The wife had to go in early, you know, in the hospital, Queen Mother Hospital, because they went, twins were due, you know. So I had to sit and watch the telly.
No, I mean, promised him I'd make it up to him. I said, one of these days we'll get there, I'll make it up to you, I'll take you. A lot of people might remember we made a record with Martin O'Neill, Shane McGowan, Echo and the Bunnymen, a whole list of people. It was called The Best Days of a Life, and that was our tribute record to the Lisbon Lions, who are my heroes, so that was our... And then we followed that up with an album, the Ultimate Celtic album, which done fantastically well. We managed to raise a lot of money for charity. So we're hoping to just keep that going, and if we can get the result tonight that I'm praying that we get, then I'd like to get a host of celebrities together to make the Ultimate Celtic single to be the tribute to this.
And what would you call it and who would be on it?
Oh, I'm still working on that, but I'm going to try and get a chance to talk to Bono later, so let's see if we can do that. I'm sure he'd be up for it.
Another Celtic fan who might just be up for it is Simple Minds frontman Jim Kerr. He now lives the lifestyle of an international jet-setter, but his heart is very much in the east end of Glasgow.
Over this past month, I've been saying it would be a bonus if Celtic would win. Sitting here on the day, I'm like, just bloody win, you know? Just win. Because this is... to come so far... But it's a football match, cup final. Anything can happen. The Celtic are the underdogs, but you'd be mental to bet against them.
Night falls and the time for talking is over. Those lucky fans with tickets get to the game, but tens of thousands without watch on big screens and in small bars.
Was going to see what Celtic is all about, you know, like there's not a travelling support in the world like Celtic, and I think we've just proved that today.
And end the game, shook hands with each other, a great atmosphere.
up to 100,000 easy over here, and they've not seen one bit of trouble tonight. Not one bit of trouble.
Very nice people.
Today you have all the evidence that you need to have that Celtic supporters are, in Spanish, singular, unique, very different. We can come here, we can enjoy the moment, we're fantastic, and we will always be remembered for that. Never forget, Celtic supporters are a breed apart. Thank you.
No commiserations tonight, just celebrations, is it?
Not one bit. I just don't know where I'm staying tonight, and I love it. Thanks very much.
UEFA bureaucracy forbids the scattering of Phil McPhee's ashes inside the stadium. Instead, the Bar 67 faithful choose the serenity of Seville's Guadalquivir River.
Sad but happy that we actually made it and brought him with us. And he's got his final wish. But it's also sad for everybody at the club and his family and everything else.
What do you think of the setting?
Beautiful, beautiful. Very warm, but really nice.
That's it then. Well, I've got a few more grey hairs after this trip. Which reminds me, Danny Smith, the barber of Seville, never did get his cup final ticket. But James Traquair did. And despite his age, the 83-year-old says his first trip away with Celtic most certainly won't be his last. From Seville, it's Slange.
I'm not very happy, but that goes for everybody.
Very, very proud of the team. I'm very proud of the supporters. I just needed you to comfort me.
And I have tried to make it. Glory seen defeat again, man. She'll never get beat over there.
It was a journey and we were brilliant and we'll be back next year. Hail, hail!
It is written of old that the land of Ireland is sought land. In